the few night elves that survived the horrific explosion, rallied together on crudely made rafts and slowly made their way to the only landmass in sight. Somehow, by the grace of Alun, Malfurion, Tyrande, and Cenarius had survived the Great Sundering. The weary heroes agreed to lead their fellow survivors and establish a new home for their people. As they journeyed in silence, they surveyed the wreckage of their world and realized that their passions had wrought the destruction all around them. Though Sargeras and his legion had been ripped from the world by the well's destruction, Malfurion and his companions were left to ponder the terrible cost of victory. There were many Highborn who did survive the cataclysm unscathed. They made their way to the shores of the new land, along with the other Night Elves. Although Malfurion mistrusted the Highborn's motivations, he was satisfied that they could cause no real mischief without the well's energies. As the weary mass of Night Elves landed upon the shores of the new land, they found that the holy mountain, Hajil, had survived the catastrophe. Seeking to establish a new home for themselves, Malfurion and the Night Elves climbed the slopes of Hajil and reached its windswept summit. As they descended into the wooded bowl, nestled between the mountain's enormous peaks, they found a small, tranquil lake. To their horror, they found that the lake's waters had been fouled by magic. Illidan, having survived the sundering as well, had reached Hyjal's summit long before Malfurion and the Night Elves. In his mad bid to maintain the flows of magic in the world, Illidan had poured his vials, which contained the precious waters from the Well of Eternity, into the mountain lake. The well's potent energies quickly ignited and coalesced into a new Well of Eternity. The exultant Illidan, believing that the new well was a gift to future generations, was shocked when Malfurion hunted him down. Malfurion explained to his brother that magic was innately chaotic, and that its use would inevitably lead to widespread corruption and strife. Still, Illidan refused to relinquish his magical powers. Knowing full well where Illidan's ruthless schemes would eventually lead, Malfurion decided to deal with his power-crazed brother once and for all. With Cenarius' help, Malfurion sealed Illidan within a vast underground barrow prison, where he would remain chained and powerless until the end of time. To ensure his brother's containment, Malfurion empowered the young warden Maeve Shadowsong to be Illidan's personal jailer. Concerned that destroying the new well might bring about an even greater catastrophe, the Night Elves resolved to leave it be. However, Malfurion declared that they would never practice the arts of magic again. Under Cenarius' watchful eye, they began to study the ancient arts of Druidism that would enable them to heal their ravaged earth and regrow their beloved forests at the base of Mount Hajal.